Hello, I'm Dave Biggs, General Manager of Wood-Mizer UK Limited. Today we're at Graythwaite Sawmill. About a year ago we held a customer day here at the Graythwaite estate where we showed a number of new machines, and the result of that open day was that the estate purchased a brand new LX450 sawmill. So shortly we'll go inside and we'll see the sawmill and see it in operation, and we'll speak to its main operator, which is Martin Phillips, who is the Wood-Mizer agent for Cumbria and the north of England.
We had a lot of logs that were sitting in the yard that we couldn't mill with our previous mill. Most of the hardwoods that we mill on the estate are they're not actually felled. This particular log came out of the park next to the main hall. It blew down over a fence and just about on our limit of 86-87 centimetres. The largest log to date that we have milled is just over 1.1 metres.
Centimetres.
So as you can see, we've got what we call the X-frame.
The new X-frame design. The drive chains that you say, there's one on each side. They come along and ride up. There's a shaft gear driven here with a single motor on the other side. So the chain comes right up, down, and then to the other end of the bed. Because we now have the extra through and through capacity, we've been able to mill a lot of them through and through and keep the weiny edge on, whereas before we had to edge them because of the restriction between the drive wheels on the old mill.
How long ago was that that you swapped over to the LX450?
We had the open day here in July last year. And I think we finally got the mill in the August last year.
So you've been running for about a year,
yeah. As far as maintenance costs go, now we sharpen all blades in-house. I do that myself, whereas before they all had to go to a specialist saw doctor.
So the Vortex blade was introduced to reduce the amount of sawdust that is left on the boards. Predominantly used with people with multi-head resaws, cutting cladding boards. As you can see, this is a board that's been cut with a Vortex blade, and the amount of sawdust is absolutely negligible that's left on there. And it makes life a lot easier. So what controls have you got for the sawmill?
Drum switch on the left, forwards and backwards. Drum switch to the right, as you're up and down. Toggle switch for the blade guide arm in and out. Another toggle switch for the debarker in and out, and a on-off switch when you're not using it. We've got set works panel, which you can program three preset programs in.
Bedrails are a new root shape, which, as Martin said, you get no bits of bark sitting on there, they just drop off. So you haven't got to worry about making sure the bedrails are clean before you put your log onto the bedrails. And the hydraulics, we have the clamp on here, has a twin rail on the clamp before making it very secure, very strong. Bi-directional chain turner, and enabling the log to be spun in either direction. The tow board at the back here is just a plain roller. The one at the front is actually a motorized roller, so we can use that to move the log or the end cant backwards and forwards on the bed to position it. These grip the cant and pull it down onto the bed, so if you have tension in your wood and the cant is lifting up at the ends, you can grab hold of it and pull it down onto the bed so that everything you cut comes off parallel.